Good morning, and thank you for joining us at the Bridgewater New Jerusalem Church to our virtual service this morning. I would like to thank everyone for being so flexible in allowing us to have a virtual service today. COVID has hit my home. Two out of four of us, and the kids are fine. Matthew is now back to school, and Emily has been home. And fortunately, they have both had mild symptoms. So I am very thankful for that. And I would like to thank everyone who reached out and sent good thoughts and prayers for the kids. So the announcements for this week are Tuesday. I will hold our spiritual discussion group at 3 p.m. And Wednesday night, we have our beginner crochet group that begins at 6 o'clock and goes till 7:30. If you are interested in either of those, I would love to see you. Masked up, of course. And I, in particular, would like to thank Dan for putting together our service today. And for Cindy and Mike, with all their help and assistance. So, once again, we are a great team, and that's what we need during these times. So I welcome you, and we are going to have our first hymn, which is Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee. Let us join in our affirmation of faith. We worship the one God, the Lord, the Savior, Jesus Christ, the Redeemer of the world, in whom is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, whose humanity is divine, who, for our salvation, did come into the world and take our nature upon him. He endured temptation, even to the passion of the cross. He overcame the hells, and so delivered man. He glorified his humanity, uniting it with the divinity of which it was begotten. Without this, no mortal could have been saved, and they are saved who believe in him and keep the commandments of his word. This is his commandment, that we love one another as he has loved us. Amen. And now I would like you to quiet your mind and your heart as we prepare for prayer and for lifting those up who we know need our special prayers this week. So let us pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for the technology that we have, that we are still able to worship together, even though we are apart. We know that there are reasons for everything, that sometimes we don't know the reasons, but we are able to choose how we respond to what goes on in our lives, Lord. We know that many of our friends and family members are facing difficult times right now. And we just pray that you are in the center of everything, that we are aware of you, and that we continue to show you our love, and that we show our love for our neighbors and others, Lord. Although not together, and it is difficult to raise up the names of those who are on our minds and hearts this morning, Lord, I know that we have been keeping in prayer Kathleen, Bill and Maureen, Jim Peters, Carol. There are many others who we lift up to you, who we know you are there, Lord, that you are with them. Many of us do not know the paths that are ahead of us, but we thank you for being there for us. And let us now pray the prayer that you have taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And now our scripture reading for today. Our Old Testament reading is from Psalm number 8. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory in the heavens. Through the praise of children and infants, you have established a stronghold against your enemies, to silence the foe and the avenger. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars, which you have set in place, what is mankind that you are mindful of them? Human beings, that you care for them. You have made them a little lower than the angels and crowned them with glory and honor. You made them rulers over the works of your hands. You put everything under their feet, all flocks and herds and the animals of the wild, the birds in the sky and the animals, the fish in the sea, all that swim the paths of the seas. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. And now from Luke chapter 15, the parable of the lost son. Jesus continued, There was a man who had two sons. The younger one said to his father, Father, give me my share of the estate. So he divided the property between them. Not long after that, the younger son got together all he had, set off for a distant country, and there squandered his wealth in wild living. After he had spent everything, there was a severe famine in that whole country, and he began to be in need. So he went and hired himself out to a citizen of that country, who sent him to his fields to feed pigs. He longed to fill his stomach with the pods that the pigs were eating, but no one gave him anything. When he came to his senses, he said, How many of my father's hired servants have food to spare, and here I am starving to death? I will set out and go back to my father and say to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants.' So he got up and went to his father. But while he was still a long way off, his father saw him and was filled with compassion for him. He ran to his son, threw his arms around him, and kissed him. The son said to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven, and against you I am no longer worthy to be called your son.' But the father said to his servants, 'Quick, bring the best robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Bring the fattened calf and kill it. Let's have a feast and celebrate. For this son of mine was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found.' So they began to celebrate. Meanwhile, the older son was in the field. When he came near the house, he heard music and dancing. So he called one of the servants and asked him what was going on. 'Your brother has come,' he replied, 'and your father has killed the fattened calf because he has been brought back safe and sound.' The older brother became angry and refused to go in. So his father went out and pleaded with him. But he answered his father, 'Look, all these years I've been slaving for you and never disobeyed your orders. Yet you never gave me even a young goat so I could celebrate with my friends. But when this son of yours, who has squandered away your property with prostitutes, comes home, you kill the fattened calf for him.' 'My son,' the father said, 'you are always with me, and everything I have is yours. But we had to celebrate and be glad, because this brother of yours was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found.'" May the Lord bless the reading and understanding of his word. We are now at our sermon. Not quite sure how we got here, but I'm glad we are. And again, thank you to everyone for helping put together this service. So I was chatting with my friend this week, and she asked me, "So what are you talking about on Sunday? What's your sermon? What's your topic? What's going on?" I said, "That's a really good question." And then we started talking about the different paths that we are on. And we talked about how sometimes our path kind of gets bumped. And it's not that we're on a different path, but that our path just kind of gets moved over a little. And we were talking about how her path has just taken a completely different turn than what she had expected. My path this week really took a big bump. I am very thankful that Emily is okay, but having COVID in your home is so different than hearing about it on the news or from friends. Oh, you know, so-and-so caught COVID. And COVID in general has kind of put us all on a different path. And this path is not what we wanted. We didn't choose to have COVID enter our lives and disrupt everything. So I was thinking, as she and I were talking, you know, getting bumped this week just sort of set me off. It set my mind to a completely different place. The littlest things were aggravating me, or I just couldn't do it. I just couldn't handle much. So, you know, my trajectory was off a little bit. So then she asked me, what brings you back to your path? And my initial answer to her was, well, what if that's not the path we're supposed to be on? What if these little bumps in the road are kind of nudges to just get us to go somewhere else? And I said to her, I said, you know, sometimes we get bumped onto these other paths, and it depends on how we are going to handle that path. Am I going to go down this other path looking for the joy, looking for the love, the happiness? Or am I going to go down this path and just mope through it and, you know, complain? And she said to me, she goes, so it depends on how you respond. I said, yeah, I think you're right. I think you're right. I also said, we have a choice. We have a choice as to whether or not we are going to follow that path that we got bumped onto. Do we really want to go back to the path that we were on? There could be a reason that we got bumped a little. And I think through the past 2.5, 3 years here, we've all gotten bumped. But at the same time, there are those things that are just steady, the things that are just continuing to move along. For instance, God is always there for us. We know that. This is nothing new. We have that constant. That's the constant in our lives. We know that. We need to reach out for that. Even if our path gets bumped, we don't know. We don't know if is that the path that we're supposed to go down. So what do? We can go back to that one thing that is continuous. We can just choose that. And if we choose not to, we might get bumped onto the other path later on. But we need to remember that we have our faith. We have our beliefs. We know that God is there for us always. There are things in life that change, and there are things in life that keep going. Life is so different now, and it will be different for our children. We all keep saying, and I hear this in the my friends who are in the older generations than mine, who say, we need to get back to normal. What is this? We need to be back to where we were. I don't know. This happened for a reason. I don't know what the reason is, but I have heard so many people say, you know, the one good thing that I have learned in this pandemic is what is a priority to me. And I have heard it from all generations. And it just amazes me that people who have been through all of this, and I would call it somewhat traumatic, because all of a sudden our world stopped, but we still had that constant. But everything stopped just for a short amount of time. And it really is nice to hear the positive. So as I was talking to my friend, We started talking about music and how music can also be a constant for us. She mentioned to me that music for her takes her back. It's almost like her saving grace. And I completely agree with her on that. I said to her, I said, you know, I think I'm going to ask everyone, what is your favorite hymn? Think of your favorite hymn right now. Why is it your favorite hymn? There's a reason. Does it bring you back to your childhood? Does it make you think of your grandparents? For me, attending church, I have so many hymns that remind me of my grandparents and family members and, you know, oh, this was their favorite song and their favorite hymn. And those are things that can help us. They really can. My friend actually said that she remembers a song that one of her teachers taught her about underlining in a paragraph. And, you know, we just talked about how important music can be. I really feel that music is such a gift from God. I have studied music. I actually have a music minor. And once you learn the simplicity and complexity of chords and their structure and transitioning from one chord to another, to think about all of these orchestral pieces, simple tunes that may even just stick with us in our mind, it's just amazing to think how it all comes together. I know that a number of times I have been driving in my car and I will put on my playlist or whatnot. And it's just amazing how music can take me away. Again, what is your choice in music and where is that taking you? That's also something to think about. There are days where some of those 80s metal bands or 80s, what do they call them? 80s hair bands are on the radio. Kind of my escape, I think. But more often than not are my Christian playlists. And to just think about the lyrics that go with the music, and I'm always listening for those harmonies, those little extra things that complete that song. And I think that what I've learned from all of this is that God helps us to be complete like music. We can be complete. It's going to take some time. Swedenborg talks about regeneration and, you know, that's what we're all doing. Regeneration, we're learning. We're learning how to live in this life so that when we get to the next life, our eternal life, that we will be that good person here. And we can will continue to be that good person. The two greatest commandments that we all know is to love the Lord and to love our neighbor. And I know that we have talked about this, and I know it's not always easy. But those are the two things that are constant. Trying to stay constant while we keep getting bumped into something else is difficult, but we can do it, and we can do it with the Lord's help, and we just need to lean on God each day. We don't know what tomorrow brings, And we need to be thankful for everything that we have, everything that's constant in our lives, and be thankful for those things that kind of bump us out of the way. Let's pray. Dear Lord, I just thank you so much for all that you have given us, for the ability to continue to be with you, to be with each other, to support each other as our lives change and get bumped. Help us to remember that you are the one constant that will always be there for us. Help us to know that there are things that we can do to become closer to you through prayer, through music, through being with others. We thank you so much for all you have done for us, and we thank you for what will come in our lives. Amen. As you go through your week, whatever path you may be on, may you remember that there is a constant in our life, and you can reach for that at any moment.